Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Okay. So, hello everybody, and welcome to the second attempt at the Google Plus EMEA platform office hours. We had a bit of a technical difficulties last time, and this time we've, well, attempted to resolve those technical difficulties. Hopefully, if we have any more problems this time, they'll be entirely new and unexpected. With me, as always, is Lee Denison.
Hi, everybody.
And over on Hangouts, joining us from Spain, is Silvano Luciani.
Hola.
Okay, cool. So today what we're going to talk about a little bit is Devfest, which is sort of happening at the moment in various places around the world. Then we're going to look at something that came out of the London Devfest, which is a Hangout application that Silvano built. So he's going to take us through that. And then finally, if we've got any questions, we'll handle that. Otherwise, we'll say goodbye and catch up with you next time. So Devfest is our sort of first point of call, and that's something that was kicked off last weekend, so not the weekend before last, in fact, in London, and is a global event with conferences happening all over the world just to investigate and celebrate various bits of Google technology and web technology and mobile technology and all the kind of cool stuff that's being built. So they're organized by the local Google developer groups in different regions, and we had the advantage of going along to the London one, but in between them we've had events in Lille, in India, we've had events in Shanghai, all over the place. It's been really amazing. And over the next few months, we've got them coming up across the world. We've got them coming up, I think, the next one's in Kyoto, which might be tomorrow, pretty soon. And if you want any more information on that, go to devfest.info, where you can see all the upcoming events. We thought it might be interesting to show you some of the pictures from Devfest London, so you can get a little bit of a feel for what it was like, and also to talk about what some of our favorite sessions were there. So Lee, I believe you've got some photos you can stick up.
Yep, so if we...
simplifying your life, making things a bit easier while making web apps of all kinds. So it comes with a whole bunch of tools already out of the box configurable for you. It's a package manager and it's a build tool that can get your application ready to go up. A very, very fantastic and useful set of functionality, and a really interesting talk from Adi, not just about Yeoman, but also about how you integrate a tool chain into your process, looking at how he uses Sublime Text and his editor to improve what he's doing, to make it a little bit more powerful, to allow him to get more done in the same amount of time. Very, very interesting talk, and definitely worth checking out Yeoman.io. There's some good intro videos on the site.
A talk, he was giving tips and tricks to developers who were looking to get the most out of Jelly Bean and to you know, take advantage of the new features that have been released in Jelly Bean, and you know, help their applications really fit in with the look and feel and the UI that's coming in Jelly Bean. So yeah, that was a great talk.
Excellent. Cool. So one of the things that we actually presented as part of DevFest was a Hangout application that we talked about. Silvano and I talked about on stage there. But if you're interested about any of the other things that are happening at the DevFests, or you'd like to check out some more events in London, do check out gdg-london.com, which is the site of the London GDG Google Developer Group. Unfortunately, the next meeting, which is next week, is all sold out. It's about cloud technologies. But stay tuned. There'll be further things coming up, so it's worth a look. But I think now one of the best things to do would be to just switch over to Silvano. And Silvano, perhaps you could take us through the application which you built.
Yeah, sure, Ian. So just let me quickly introduce the story of the app. The app is called Being Polirish. Polirish is a developer advocate for Chrome, based in the United States. And in July, he came to London visiting his members based in London, with other team members coming from the US. And they did one of these Google Developers Live events for the Chrome platform. And when they came back to the area where we sit all together in the office, Paul Kinlan was saying, oh, it would be really cool if we could have Paul Irish appearing in all of our Hangouts. And I was there listening and I said, yeah, we can do that. So we took a couple of pictures of Paul and then I brought this and now I will show it to you,
Paul Irish,
in the Hangout. So you can see this nice overlay of Paul's face and the animation of the mouth, which is more or less going on when I'm speaking. The app is a very simple app, and I like to show it in the source code to you, if we can go with the slides.
Yep, sure thing. So I've got those up now.
This is from the slide deck that Ian and I used at the GDG at the Devfest London, and this is the way you can launch the app. So using an Hangout button, it's very, very simple code. It's mostly all of it is boilerplate, and the only thing that you need to personalize is the ID of your app that you can get from the Google API console. If we can go to the next slide. So this is an example of a standard Hangout app. And when I say standard, I mean that this is XML code. But we have published a service, which is called the Hangout iFramer, that will allow you to write your app using pure HTML. And then the Hangout iFramer will take care of wrapping your code into an XML in an iframe inside the Hangout. And you can find more about this at hangoutbots.blogspot.com. And I personally recommend to use it because I like HTML code more, way better than XML code in my editor. If we go to the next, we can see this is the beginning in the head of the code. One thing that I'm doing and that I wanted to show with this app is initializing Google Analytics. It's very important when you write an Hangout app to be able to measure the engagement that the app is generating with your user. And Google Analytics is the most straightforward way of doing it. And you don't need anything special when it comes to Hangout apps. It's just another web property as any website. So this is the plain standard boilerplate code that you can get when you create a property on Google Analytics. And the only thing that you will need to change is, of course, the code for your property. And we will see later how to be able to push events, to be able to track, for instance, when users are performing some actions on your Hangout app. The most important part is at the end of the code, when we include a dependency for the Hangout API and then the Hangout API itself. So, please go. Next slide, please. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is all my initialization code. It's a bunch of variables that I use to store the frames for the animation. It's very simple. We have six frames. It's basically Paul's face and then Paul's face with different degrees of openness, let's say, of his mouth. Then we have a couple of messages that we use for the button that enables and activate the overlay on the face. And then the most important part is at the end. Before we start doing anything inside an Hangout app, we need first to be sure that we have loaded the API. And for this, we use the on API ready event, and we add the listener, which in this case is the function init up. If we can move to the next slide, please. This is init up. And once again, all I'm doing is just organizing my logic for preparing some of the thing, like getting the participant ID for the local participant, which we will use later to get the changes in the volume for the local participant. And then the init functions for the overlays, the sounds, and the events that we add to the user interface. Next slide. Now, init overlays is the most important like function in this application, where the main part is played by the overlay of Polaris face over the local participant face. As you might know, if you've used already the API, first you need to create an image resource from a PNG file hosted on HTTP, preferably. And then once we have the image resource, on top of the image resource, we can create the overlay, specifying where we want the overlay to be put. In this case, is the nose tip, because it's more or less in the center of the face, so that our face overlay will be centered all over the face. One thing that I wanted to show is one addition from the latest version of the API, V1.2. And is the fact that we can now manage the resources. So we can decide to perform some action just when the state of the image resource change. And we can use this also for sounds and overlays. So in this case, what we do is we check, and when an image is actually loaded, we call the image loaded function. As we will see later, what this does is making sure that the button that enables to show the overlay is activated only when we have already loaded all the image that are the frames for our animation. In this case, I'm not doing anything particularly useful in the case that the image is not loaded. I'm just writing a message to the console. But of course, you could try, for instance, to reload the image resource if there's been some problem. Or send more meaningful messages to the user. In init sounds, it shows another addition of V1.2 of the API. And in this case, init sounds, when I show the face of Paul Irish, there's also a salute from Paul that I ripped off one of his very, very interesting video. It's the one on 12 tips on the Chrome Dev Tools that I strongly recommend to watch. And the addition from the V1.2 is the possibility of create sounds which are global, meaning that they are not played only on the local instance of the app, but they are, let's say, broadcasted. So every instance of the app will play the sound. And in this case, as you see, we use the local-only parameter, setting it to false. And this means that the sound will be global and everyone will be saluted by Paul in the moment where we apply the overlay. Next slide, please. And these are just the okay. So this is the function that actually does the activate or deactivate the overlay. It's very simple. So we add or remove a listener to the volume change event. With the Hangouts API, we can get updates on the volume of each participant. In this case, the volume is the input on the microphone. So what we do is, if the overlay is active, we add a listener that will animate the mouth when the volume changes. And otherwise, we remove the listener so that there's no animation. One important thing is at the end. There you can see how easy it is to track events with analytics. It's just calling the push function with track event parameter, and then you can define your own event. In this case, our label is the feeling button, is the way I call this event. And I'm tracking with event field if people feel like Paul or they don't feel like Paul. meaning that I will see how many times they click to show or hide the overlay. And as you can see, it's very simple, and you can use it for all kind of interactions and actions that user can perform on your app. And this is the function that animate them out. Once again, it's quite easy. So what we do, we check the volumes of our local participant. To do so, we need the participant ID, because on this event, the parameter for this event is an array keyed by participant ID. What we do, if the volume is more than zero, we animate the mouth, and otherwise we just show the frame with the mouth closed, meaning that we are not speaking. And that's all.
Cool. All right, Silvano, thanks. So that just goes to show you really how simple it is to put together a app using Hangouts. It's really something that you can do very, very easily, very, very quickly. And it's not something that really requires a great deal of investment of time to get going. It's one of the nice things, you can do it basically as a joke, which is what the result of the Paul Irish app is. The other thing that's really important to remember with Hangouts is that that kind of app with doing something like a facial overlay or something on the screen works, but it's not the only kind of app you can build. You also have the flexibility to put a iframe into the main section of the Hangout app and build whatever you want in there. So that kind of last slide you just saw a little bit of at the end, that was from a game called Warlight, which is a really fun kind of Risk style game that you can play via Hangouts with your friends. And you can build anything like that into your application. So you can go and take an application which exists somewhere else and add video chat to it with a Hangout, or you can go and build some crazy new experience or new kind of game that works within the Hangout. So it's very, very flexible and definitely something that's worth looking into. If you're interested in doing more with Hangouts or you'd like to try something out, if you go to developers.google.com/plus, that's the plus sign, /hangouts, then you'll find sample apps, you'll find API documentation, you'll find lots and lots of stuff to help you get started. And we'll put a link to that in the post on Plus about the show. So that was the kind of Google Plus presentation at DevFest London. I hope it was interesting for everyone. The rest of the day on Friday actually was filled up with a couple more presentations, and then we went down and did some lightning talks with people like Ilmari Häkkinen. Gave a really, really great talk about doing images, multiple resolution images, and a few other people talking about some things that made a difference to them or that they wanted to share with people. And then on the Saturday we actually had a hackathon. So the hackathon was a really interesting day full of coding, building projects based on all these different technologies, and people came up with games, with applications for doing video streaming via Get User Media in the browser, with all sorts of different things, which made it just a really, really great day to be around. So I would definitely say if there is a DevFest near you, get along to it, check it out, and see if there's anywhere you want to speak or anywhere you just want to go along to. So I think that's probably about it from me, unless we've got any questions. Let's just quickly.
I've just had a quick look, and I've not seen any questions on the Dory, so I think that's it.
Excellent. Well, apologies again to everyone that turned up last week and suffered through our technical difficulties, but hopefully we've got them sorted out. It looks like this week has gone okay. Particular apologies to the amazing Gervin Sturm, who we brought along last week and then completely failed to get on air. So Gervin, we will get back with you in the future. We'd love to have you on now that we have some idea what we're doing. So thank you. I think that's it from me.
And that's it from me.
All right. See you later, guys.
Bye.